I just used to throw myself about, leap up like horizontal and sideways, just like boing, 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 boing. You'd like land on them and smash them into the floor.
My name is Nick Kent. I'm a once-renowned journalist for the New Musical Express, or Sid, as he was known then, who I'd encountered once before. I'd not actually met him. Was obviously under the influence of some sort of amphetamines or extreme adrenaline propulsing stimulants. Sid Vicious was looking for a fight.
Just fucking watch out, pal, right? Otherwise I'll fucking slice you open.
He hit me over the head a few times with a chain, which didn't require any stitches, fortunately. I sort of wandered upstairs in a complete lava of blood and confusion. I truly admire their attitude. I thought it was very brave. Immediately before this attack occurred, John Rotten was deep in discussion with Sid. I figure that Johnny, as he's known, was setting me up. This is all true. In fact, Sid got the name Vicious from that fight. John Rotten christened him Vicious from that fight, said he falling against the door.
Sid Vicious got the name after my pet hamster that bit him one day. And he was trying to be sweet to it. And its name was Sid. And he really liked that. Your Sid is vicious.
The group were doing a very private, I think secret show at the Screen on the Green, Islington. Well, I went along with a couple of our A&R people and Chris Wright, the chairman. Knocked on the door. Somebody opened the door and said, fuck off. Well, we weren't going to be dissuaded, so we tapped on the door again and said, we're invited. And then the head popped round again and said, fuck off.
They were a particularly ugly band. Oh, they're so pretty, oh, so pretty. We're vacant, oh, we're so pretty, oh, so pretty. Oh, vacant, don't ask us to return, cos they're not all there. I don't pretend, cos they're not. And there was a little bit of a scuffle, nothing much. Musicians to defend themselves if the thing goes on to stage. I've never seen musicians drop their instruments and sort of dive in a small scrap and extend it and forget about the music, and I found that a bit much.
I went back two or three times after that just to make sure that, you know, they were as bad as I thought they were the first time.
Why all the in famous language? Infamous language, you're joking. I speak nothing but the fucking English language. And if that's infamous, then ha ha ha.
Tough titters.
Basically, the Pistols' attitude to the press was one of completely, like, fuck you, you know? I mean, just absolutely fuck you. Which was great. I mean, it was a perfect antidote to all the 99% of other stupid rock groups who, like, lick the arse of the press. And, I mean, it worked perfectly for them. Most journalists are masochists. They just toss pots most of the time.
Don't accept the old order. Get rid of it.
We've been there for 5 years or more just waiting for this to happen. And now it's happened.
It had to. It was the only thing that could happen. It was the only thing that didn't come from the industry. It came from the kids themselves. Something had to come from the kids.
The leaders of a whole new teenage cult that seems to be on the way to being as big as Mods and Rockers were in the 60s. The cult is called punk. The music, punk rock, basic rock music, raw, outrageous and crude, like their fan magazine, Sniffing Glue.
I think our music is very honest. It's the most honest thing that's been happening in the last 15 years. Nothing to beat it.
Finding places to play is becoming harder, thanks to the reputation punks are getting as troublemakers. And the Sex Pistols themselves even had to hire a strip club to get their music heard. Nowhere else would take them.
Down the street. The pistol is very believable. I find it's all related to violence in the mind, not in the body.
Malcolm began to get a little bit serious about it, and he brought in a lawyer by the name of Fisher.
That dreadful lawyer whose name I refused to speak.
There was basically an auction between Polydor and EMI.
We came up with a contract which gave the Pistols total creative control.
Malcolm decided to go with EMI.
I went into the A&R department and said, who are these crazy guys, man? I mean, who are they? This is the Sex Pistols, we just signed them. They're tremendous. And my first actual plug for them was after all this, was by phoning up the Today programme. They phoned me and said, yes, we'd like to use the Sex Pistols, you know, will they be okay? I said, well, sure, I'm sure they'll be all right.
He slung us in a green room with a fridge, and I remember downing about fucking 4 bottles of Blue Nun, and I was fucking just having a good old time pissed at this point by the time we went out there, and that's all I remember.
They are punk rockers, the new craze, they tell me. They're heroes, not the nice clean Rolling Stones. You see, they're as drunk as I am. They are clean by comparison. They're a group called the Sex Pistols. I am told that group have received £40,000 from a record company. Doesn't that seem to be slightly opposed to their anti-materialistic view of life?
More to marry.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Well, tell me more about it.
You fucking spent it, haven't we?
I don't know, have you?
Yeah. Yeah, it's all good.
No one even heard that one, because he was drunk himself, and he wasn't paying attention. When he asked, well, what do you do with the money? And I said, we fucking spent it.
Well, tell me more about it.
You fucking spent it, haven't we?
I don't know, have you?
Yeah,
yep.
It's all gone.
Really?
Down
the boozer. Really? Good Lord. Now, I want to know one thing. Beethoven, Mozart, Bach, Brahms have all died.
Ours,
they? Really?
Oh,
what are we saying, sir?
Wonderful people.
Are they?
Oh, yes, they really turn us on.
What do they do?
Well, suppose they turn other people on.
That's just their tough treat.
And rotten, he slipped up and said shit under his breath.
It's what?
Nothing, a rude word. Next question.
No, no. What was the rude word?
Shit.
Was it really? Good heavens, you frightened me to
death. Oh, all right.
What about you girls behind?
Right, your dad, isn't he, this gamer?
Are you,
With your granddad.
Are you worried, or are you just enjoying yourself?
Enjoying myself.
Are you?
Yeah.
That's what I thought you were doing.
I always wanted to meet you.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Susie, she was just being, like, coy with him. And he said, oh, maybe we'll meet after.
We'll meet afterwards, shall we?
You dirty son. You dirty old man.
Steve completely understood that he was talking to a drunk, as you would a drunk in a pub, and he just topped him.
Well, keep going, Chief, keep going. Go on, you've got another 5 seconds. Say something outrageous.
You dirty bastard.
I just remember this fucking cunt just started provoking us, and we coated him off.
Go on, again.
You dirty fucker.
What a clever boy.
What a fucking rotter.
Well, that's it for tonight. The other rocker, Abel, I'm saying nothing else about him, will be back tomorrow. I'll be seeing you soon. I hope I'm not seeing you again. From me, though, good night.
McLaren was there. He was terrified. He was shitting himself.
With Beth White, you know, going, we fucking better get out of here, quick.
But the very next day, it was all his big idea, you know.
It was perfect stand-up comedy. It was Arthur-esque.
That's all. A four-letter word done everything.
We'll be right back.
I loved it. I fucking loved it. It was like, finally, I've arrived. And the circus had begun.
The committee have decided that, in fairness to the public of Derby, Sex Pistols will not perform here tonight, but we are quite agreeable that the three other groups that have already been booked will go on.
For the last 12 months, punk rock has become almost a battle cry in British society. For many people, it's a bigger threat to our way of life than Russian communism or hyperinflation, and it certainly generates more popular excitement than either of those.
We hope tonight, by this protest, to make Wales know, to let the people of this town know, that we do protest,